tournament is still underway in Turkey, and our boys, of course, did us a lot of proud by beating favourites Portugal 3-2. We actually showed Nigeria how to beat Portugal and eliminate them from the competition. But tomorrow is a big test as well for the boys. They come up against Chile, who have a very strong forward, a guy there called Nicolas Castillo or Castillo, whatever his name is. But that guy is he's on fire, and so it's going to be very interesting tomorrow, but I know we're going through. On the show this morning, let's welcome Emmanuel Agyeman Badu, who plays for Udinese. Good to see you, Agyeman.
Good to see you tonight.
You're very punctual, actually. I was really surprised. You were here at 8:15.
I live in Europe, so it's normal.
Thanks for the reminder. Thanks for the reminder. I was really impressed that you got here on time. Well, and he's flanked to his left by Sandra Apenu. She hosted Talented Kids on TV3. Did you learn to rap from that little boy? What's his name?
Tutula Party.
Tutula Party, yes.
I'm still learning.
You're still learning. Anyway, good to see you. And you showed that you don't live in Europe. You were so late.
There's a system.
Yeah, which system?
Why people eat into your time, you also have to eat into other people's time.
All right, so good to see you. And Juliet Bewa, who had no reason to be late, she couldn't afford to be late because she knows the repercussions. Good to see you as well. So we're going to discuss the under-20s. You've won the under-20 World Cup before, so you know how it feels to be there, you know, to be bashed as well. Tell me, as you watch these boys, what goes through your mind?
Yeah, I just remember our time 2009 when we won the tournament in Egypt. So I'm just throwing challenges to them to do well so that they also can win this tournament for Mother Ghana. Because it's been at least 3 years, we're not doing well. So I'm throwing a challenge to them to do well and to win the cup.
Okay, and you did it for the under-20s, but we always see the transition. For Black Stars, you guys haven't won anything. I mean, what have you guys won? Nothing, except games.
Yeah,
you don't win trophies. You're like Arsenal.
No, it's not like that. We've been trying to win something because it's been years, like 31 years, we haven't won anything for the country.
Mm-hmm.
We've been trying, but the luck is not there. But I hope next year, for sure, the luck will start coming. We start winning trophies for the country.
Okay, yeah. We'll see what happens. Anyway, you've been following the boys. We are meeting Chile tomorrow. You've seen Chile play. What do you think?
It's going to be very difficult. But maybe I can sit here and just say the Black Satellites are going to win, maybe by this margin, because clearly we've met them twice at the senior level. That's when the Black Stars drew 1-1 in a friendly match. And in 93 as well, also under 17 in Japan, where we won. So
3-0 or something.
Yeah, we won. So clearly going into this game, we've not met in the under 20 level. So it's going to be a very different game. And Salasteta wouldn't know what to expect. But I think over these past few days or maybe weeks, he has shown that he is the man in charge, because clearly some of us started losing hope in the squad because of...
You lost hope completely. You were not even watching the
almost.
Games.
Almost.
No, no, you did.
Almost.
You did. Because the last time hope. When they played the USA, I asked you where you were. And you said, you were somewhere. So I said, come, let's watch the game. She said, for what?
Well,
let me know when they score. She didn't watch the game.
You never know. Maybe I was watching the game
somewhere.
No,
you were not.
maybe I was watching the game somewhere. But we almost lost hope. And you have to be honest. And I'm being honest with you. I almost lost hope in the squad, but I think they proved us wrong when they took on USA and they won by that margin. And you saw the kind of play that they showed. They learned from their mistake. They learned from the past two games that they have played. And also they build up when they played against
Portugal,
which everybody thought they were favorite. And definitely they were favored because among the two strikers, Bruma and Cole, they've scored 9 goals, 5 mm-hmm. goals and 4 goals each. So getting into this game, you would fear for the likes of maybe Nketiah, Latte, that they can't hold the strikers. But I think they took Ghana for granted, and the Black Satellite did what the most important thing, getting 2 substitutes on the field and they scoring the goals.
Grabbed 2 goals.
Yeah, I think exactly. It speaks volumes about Salasteta.
Okay, you think that the team that won against Portugal should be changed?
No, I think that, sorry to say that, like Julia said, it started on a very poor note. So most of us, we were not following the games anymore. But I think tactically, the coach got it along the line. He decided to play a striker with our last match that we had with Portugal. And I think that really worked for us. And so looking at Chile and the history that we've had with them over the years, I think that if he stuck to that, the coaching tactic that he used in the match between Portugal, I think it will gradually work for us. The one striker thing, I think, really worked for us. The beginning, it was Matrai Makwe kind of, game they were playing. And
one of the coaches.
One will ask, why is Nigeria who was doing so well,
Oh, I'm so happy right. Nigeria is out.
Wow, but they were performing so well. They were doing so well, And they are out. So it was just, yay, by miracle.
They are out. Agyeman, Bobo better than any of us here. Yeah. Tell us about him. When you're losing a game, like we saw against Portugal came back, equalized, scored again, and then we had to fight very hard. When if you're a player on the pitch with Bobo on the touchline, what's the communication like?
Well, he's one coach. He have really helped me in my career, and he's welcomed when he's losing the game. He just have to be well concentrated on the game so that after the recess he can have something for the team. And I spoke with him before their first game, like how so many people saw the game. They didn't start the tournament very well, but they came in strongly against the Spanish. Mm-hmm. After that, we were able to beat USA 4-1, and we continued to fought so hard to beat Portugal as well. So he's happy now, and he's looking forward for tomorrow's game. But I hope with the quality and with the now they are getting the cohesion, the teamwork is working.
Yeah,
you see the central defense, Atama and Lawrence. You can see that they are communicating very well now, and the strikers have started scoring the goals. So I hope tomorrow we'll get a win so that we can qualify for the semifinals.
Okay. And he's mentioned a very critical point, the central midfield now clicking. You noticed that as well?
Yeah, because clearly when you watched our first game, I think he tried using Duncan. He tried a couple of players, and he didn't get the results that he, Silas Tete, wanted. So he made the changes. And I remember going back and forth with Michael Otieje on Twitter, that he said the coach is he made those changes. And I said, yeah, he's supposed to. That's why we put him there. And I think he proved many of us wrong. And bringing in some of the players, Michael Anaba came in there. Yeah. He's not impressed so many people, but I think he just did the right thing at the right time. But talking about the game, beating going to the next schedule, definitely. We should remember that there is a certain France and Uzbekistan game going on, and
France are on fire.
Yeah, they are. But if we qualify to the next stage, and they France managed to beat Uzbekistan,
we'll then beat France.
Okay.
Yeah, sure.
We'll beat France. Please.
Oh, okay.
Julius, you can see the boys have started playing so well, and
exactly.
Like the tactics have changed, and with the inclusion of this guy, I don't normally know him, but he's really impressed me. Salifu.
Salifu.
He plays for Wild Stars, or I don't know the team he plays for. In the midfield, he's
solid.
Excellent player.
Doing the like dirty works. We are going to win.
And you see the likes of the number 10, what's the name? Clifford Abuaji.
Yeah.
Doing the killer passes. So the team is solid now. And whoever we meet, we're just going for it.
You've been following the game.
Yeah.
You have passes. Been. The killer passes. Yeah, I like that. Killer passes. Exactly.
After Bobo, he'll be next.
Yeah, the next coach. Yeah. Do you have any ambitions to be a coach one day?
Maybe. But let's see how my career goes then after.
Okay. But by the way, let me just state that he plays for Udinese, of course, that one everybody knows. But he's a huge fan of Manchester United.
Oh. Yeah, for sure. Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. The Liverpool. And there goes the Liverpool fan.
Oh. Do you remember he's in the Europa League?
And we have but,
no, yeah, you beat them, right?
Anfield,
yeah, you,
yes.
you beat them at Anfield. That's yeah. true.
And
that's
it was amazing.
That game was tough.
Are we here to discuss very, very. Liverpool?
No, we'll come back to that. It's just, but this is the Diva Show. We just throw everything in.
He wants to be on.
Clearly, we have. We've got a Manchester United player. In Uzbekistan, Varela, the left back, and
oh,
I think
like
he'll
we
be
just
playing.
Bought
yeah.
him. Anyway, let's talk to you about the under-20s. Tomorrow against Chile, what's your prediction?
Ooh. It's going to be a tough match, but I predict that Ghana will win by 2-1.
Amen.
Amen.
2-1.
Yes.
Okay. If you win this prediction, if you get it right, yeah. what do you want? Agyeman Badu's hammer.
No.
Range over.
I want a range, yes.
So I have to buy a range.
Please, I want a range, yes.
I'm sorry, I have to just let Bobo know this.
Why do you have to tell Bobo? I'm
so that I have some of the bonus so that I can add to mine that you bought a car for you.
Anyway, so what's your prediction for tomorrow?
Oh, Nana, I don't normally predict, but I hope the guys will get luck and favor in tomorrow's game so that because of the coach, I want the team to win. And
you love the coach a lot.
Yeah. He's a fantastic coach, and he has helped me in my career as well. And yeah, I will pray for him this night, and I'm hoping tomorrow.
Fasting, no.
Agyeman Badu doesn't fast.
No.
He's fufu and
fufu.
Will never go. Yeah. And you know one thing about him? I was chatting with him one day. We're discussing a game onto a BB, and I said to him that you, these Black Stars boys, eh? When you come to Ghana, show voice. If you don't win this game tonight, and he said, oh, I'm eating fufu. When I eat fufu, I score goals. And truly, he just scored a goal, and I was shocked. Right after he sent me a text and said, I told you so. You know, so his fufu works for him. But you get fufu to eat in Italy a lot.
Yeah.
That's true.
Fufu no, 2 a.m. No.
The one that is.
No, the powder. But when I come to Ghana, I go to my village, the then the one you pound.
The sweat enters.
Yeah, my mom. 7 o'clock, she will be awake.
7 a.m.
Yeah.
Pounding fufu for you.
Yeah. I'll be awake at 9, then.
The fufu will be ready. Which village is this?
I'm from Sekwa.
In the Bonohafu
yeah.
region.
Where I see Nkeja comes from. He's well known than me, so I mentioned his name, everyone knows where.
Exactly.
Where
now let's go for expectations for the game tomorrow.
Certainly, as a Ghanaian, you would expect that, I would say. But it's going to be a very tough match. But eventually, I think we'll overcome the Chilean. I say this because they will be scared by the feat we have achieved. Here was a team which was almost getting out of the tournament at the preliminary stages. Then all of a sudden, they see the team rather building up, whilst other bigger names are rather coming down. Everybody expected Portugal to be one of those contenders for the trophy. And we beat them at, I mean, we made them look ordinary, you know, USA, you know. So it's like we are on the ascendancy, and Chile is already scared. So they'll be cautious. And we are proud. We have nothing to lose. We have our nose ahead. And therefore, I strongly suspect the boys are more motivated, and I'm motivated to support them the most.
The day you and Co were able to make it, and they made the nation proud, so surely we do have trust in them that they can make it. Thank you.
I realized that their performance against Portugal was better than the earlier matches, so I expect them to win against Chile.
I believe very well that Ghana is going to win. I believe in our players, and I think they can really do much. And good. So, Ghana all the way.
I'm quite optimistic about, you know, our next match, and I believe we are going to pull in, you know, more goals. We are really going to win the game, I believe so.
I know Ghana will by all means win because of their previous performance with Portugal. How we beat them, we will by all means beat Chile too.
We are just hoping for victory, and we want to see our players come back home with the cup.
I'm expecting a win and the best formation from our coach to be used on the field.
We don't want a draw, we want a win. That's what we are expecting.
All right, you're welcome back to the Diva Show. My hair by Cookies Parlor in Osu. And of course, my outfit by Rated Clothing in East Legon. I'll give you their details very soon. So, well, there's a lady called Arabna on this show who just wants to put things in my ears. Can my pot be closed? Thank you. Right, so let's move on. A lot of messages in here. Sena Tonu says, Agyeman Badu is a very funny guy, great player. Rudy Maney says that I took in a bottle of beer just because you made us proud when you scored the final penalty against Brazil. You remember that one?
Yeah.
Okay. Dear Agyeman Badu, Dear Nanaba, tell senior Agyeman Badu I said hi. This is coming from Mr. Ray, a.k.a. El Magnifico. Osman Wahab says, Liverpool will always beat Man United. Really?
Yeah, but...
When was the last time you beat us? Udinese will beat us. When was the last time you... Win trophies, win the league, then we'll know you're champions. Rudy says, welcome to the great family. Glory, glory, Man United. Okay, we're not talking about United yet. Nanatel... Agyeman Badu, he's looking great, but he should come support Chelsea. Would you support Chelsea?
Maybe because of Asian.
But would you ever support them? Will you choose Chelsea over us, over United?
No way, but when Asian is playing, yes.
No, but if... Okay, so if Chelsea is playing Man United?
Without Asian or with East Asian?
Oh, please. What kind of caveat is this?
No, just let me know.
Without Asian?
Man U.
Okay, I know you are a huge fan of Michael Asian. Huge, huge fun.
Very, very.
Yeah. What's between the two of you? I mean, I know people will say, what are you implying?
When I have a call up first time, we went to, I think, Gabon. And after training, I was quiet because I was
new.
A new day. And he called me in the room and, like, I was Abba fresh. He called me in his room and he was, like, talking to me and how, like, stuff like that. So, and after... I remember their last Champions League game against Manchester.
In Moscow.
Yeah, when he came home, we played a second game against Gabon in Ghana after he gave me the Champions League boot.
And
I really love him.
That's so sweet. Because I remember one time Ghana was playing and then I put it on my BB that, go Ghana! You know, my usual noise. And then Essien said, is Agyeman Badu playing?
Oh.
You know, so I was kind of shocked that of all the players, why did he ask
him? I love him.
You love him?
Yeah,
love him. Oh, bless your soul. Yeah. That's nice. Anyway, you've been following the Black Stars for a while.
Fire for fire.
You don't pay
attention to him.
Sorry?
No, go ahead. Don't pay attention.
You've been following them for a while. We'll come to the Black Stars very soon. Let's not take the attention of boys tomorrow. They really need it. Sandra predicting 2-1. Agyeman Badu saying that luck and favor will be with them. And so we are winning in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Can I get a huge amen from
you? Amen.
Yeah. She's a non-believer. What's your prediction?
If the game doesn't go to extra time, that is 1-1, maybe it goes to extra time.
It won't go to extra time. Okay. We're beating them.
Okay, then we all want to see good football, definitely. So if it goes to extra time, we will still get to enjoy the players so that they win and win huge. So 3-1, 2-1.
Okay. Did they play penalties? Our boys have played penalties, right?
No, they haven't.
Oh, okay. Oh, no, they haven't.
They haven't.
But I'm praying for no penalties because when it comes to penalties, we have...
You see the
penalties?
Have our Black Stars, Black Satellite, Black whatever. Their penalty-taking sessions are terrible.
Why?
I think we should get you people... Did you watch Italy, Spain?
Yeah.
Did you see the penalties?
Yeah.
My Colombia. God.
One team won, yeah?
Yeah.
So it's normal.
But you people, sometimes the way you even step forward to take the penalties, like models.
Like some of them have waist problem. They just... and then
mention a name.
I don't want to commit myself.
Okay, I know who you're talking about.
Do you know who I'm talking about?
The person has an initial. The initial is just like our president. JM. We're taking a break. We'll be back. All right, you're welcome back to the Diva Show on TV3. Let's go through the messages in here. Why are you mentioning me in your tweets, Juliet? Anyway, Richard says, hoping to see Agyeman Badu next season. And I'm sure he had a great season. Of course, he had a very great season with Udinese. Sir Edges Sekendi says, tactically, I don't think Bobo and his boys can go far. Well, that is why it remains your opinion. Nana Boateng, thank you for your message. And this is not a request show, so I'm not doing your request. The birthday request, I'm not doing it. Kelly Adoedu says, I'm loving your show this morning. Your guests are fabulous, especially Agyeman Badu, of course. Rudy says, Sandra, did I hear you well? They will kill you. Nobody can kill you for freeing your mind. I mean, I hear there's a promotion like, talk and go to prison.
No, but when I say kill you, I don't mean
you. Right. Agyeman Badu is not a serious Man United fan. I would have told Moyes to bar him. Well, ask Agyeman Badu if he ate fufu before coming on your show, or he will eat after. Right after this, he'll go to Bush County. That's his second home.
Yeah.
Okay, so a correction here. Varela plays for Uruguay, not Uzbekistan. And this message from Kojomo is so full of mischief. Kojomo, I am not asking that question. King Kendrick Lamar says, Badu loves fufu pa. Yes, sir. Abinache Bafo says, Agyeman Badu is too much. Opoku Yao Steven says, Agyeman, I think you're a good player. You speak reality. What's that? Okay, you're realistic. I guess that's what you want to say. Please take every game. Oh, yeah. So a lot of love there for you on Twitter.
Okay, I love them too.
You do, right?
Yeah.
Funny face, don't cough here. Anyway, just to tell you that they... Funny Face Fun Festival, FFFF, is ongoing at the Ifo Sunderland Children's Park. Ifo Sunderland Children's Park, And it's happening live. Adebayo is there. The rest, I don't know. Fred Yama is also there as well. And security is tight.
Operating manager.
Okay, Funny Face, you can come on stage now. You're disturbing. Just walk on. No, just
let
walk on.
Let me walk on. You go like, what do you like? Look at your camera like James Bond camera. Your camera is so big, you are telling me you walk like. Look at your camera like.
Agyeman Badu, how do you call this hairstyle?
I don't know yet. But then activate any we have peer pressure.
You know, it's peer pressure.
Now, all the footballers are resistant. That means why?
Yeah.
I'm joining. But now I'm wearing my own stuff. You see, this is the Funny Face, you can see at the back, this is the Swagon Papa. You know, I wear my own stuff.
Okay, I'm giving you just 1 minute to promote your show and go.
Really?
1 minute.
But I'm your poodle.
Yes, you're my poodle.
Oh, so what do
no, sit
do?
Down.
What do poodle do? Oh my God.
Poodle. Yeah, go on. Before then, what's your prediction? What's your prediction for the game tomorrow?
Oh, we'll make sure we are going to win because the more blasters win, the more I get money.
But it's not blasters. What would he be doing there if blasters were playing? So who are we playing?
Tahiti.
Are you serious?
Yeah.
Who are we playing? And who is playing?
Anyway? I know the team.
Okay, who's playing?
Pardon?
Who?
But I know the team.
Which team are we playing? Agyeman, don't tell him. Funny face.
Yes.
You.
Do you know? Let me explain.
Okay.
My show has been on my mind. The Funny Face Fan Festival has been on my mind. Ambulance check, police check. And I have like so many police people, about 60, 70 police people coming over. Security is tight. Ambulance is tight. And everybody is on point. So my mind has been on my show.
Uh-huh.
That's why I thought it was tight. But after my
it's
show.
Chile.
Yeah, sure. No, Chile in Tahiti, there is something common. Chile in Tahiti. No, it rhymes. There is a rhyme somewhere. That's okay. What I'm saying right there.
And the ticket is only going for 2 cities.
2 cities. And only. You should go see people there now. Oh, this today, I love you. But let me say this to the camera. I know you're watching me right there in your homes for today, please.
Actually, you're looking very good, huh?
Really?
Yeah.
You should have said that earlier. I look so fine, our money is good.
Yeah.
Today come there, I'll sing all my animal songs. That's what's up. I have a new song with Beyonce, Kakalika. I'm performing that song today and with his band as well. I'm dropping out as well, Apotro. It's like that. You know what I'm saying? We're going BET, baby. That's what I'm saying. God bless Ghana.
In the under 20 tournament,
yeah,
which player has impressed you most?
You like that answer? The FunnyFace Fan Festival has impressed me most.
Okay.
In the tournament is on the 6th of July, that is today. And in the tournament is at the Children's Park.
The Eva Sutherland Children's Park, and that's where the FunnyFace Fan Festival is going on. I actually called him, dragged him here to be on the show because I think it's a great thing. It's only two cities, very charitable. You've got to be there. If you have any kids that you think, you know, need the fun today, take them there. And as I said, Shay Adebayo is there at the moment, and he's taking pictures with all these kids.
Nana, it's beautiful. I don't know why.
You want to dance. Michael, do you have a song for him? Okay, let's go. FunnyFace. And while you're at it, just walk off as well.
Oh, okay. So what is the song?
What is the song?
That song is song. Almost here.
Song.
You can start dancing.
No, I can't. I'm not a mumu dancer. I need to hear a song before, you know.
Michael, do you have a song? Can we play it so he goes away? I have serious things to talk about.
Oh. Michael, can you play it? Oh, what a pity. Michael, I think you have a problem. You need a psychologist.
Michael, what's the song? Okay. Is that Amanda? Do Amanda. Amanda, please. I'm Al-Qaeda. Al-Qaeda.
You can't even do Al-Qaeda in this world. They say play song.
Bye-bye. All right, thank you very much. Oh, God. This guy's a character, isn't he? Agyeman, what do you think about FunnyFace?
He's a wonderful guy.
Yeah, he is. Yeah. I think he should have played football.
No, he can't.
He can't, eh?
He's too funny to play football.
Anyway, so which player has impressed you most?
So far, the Salifu didn't start the tournament, but since he came in, he's been wonderful for the team. And so I'll go for that guy, Salifu. Siedu, or what's the name? He's playing the midfield, the defensive midfield, wearing the number 8 jersey. And as you can see, the 8 jersey is
sacred. Who has impressed you most?
I think I'll still go. Not impressed me the most, but I think I'll still give it to Messi for, because he'd come after the African U Championship, what he did, and coming into this tournament, he started off a bit slowly, but I think he psyched up his mind very well psychologically. He told himself never to give up, and we all saw what the kind of goal that he scored. I think against USA.
Yeah.
So
yeah.
I think he's doing well.
Okay, Sandra.
No, is it Sifo the striker? Is it the one who's a striker?
Yeah,
yes,
yeah.
I think, I don't know his name, but I think he's doing very, very well. Yes,
okay, so he's impressed you
very much.
So we asked other people as well which player has impressed them the most in the tournament, and interesting names that came up. We'll go for it now.
Of course, it's Richmond Bwachi Yadom. Yeah, that guy, he has done well.
The spin. I trust play the spin. And also Ghana.
I would say the satellite against Spain. That game, I really love the way the satellite handled the whole game from the first minute to the 90th, even though they lost. I really like the way they possessed and they were a little bit much organized than their previous game.
To be very honest with you, the Nigerians were very impressive. They went out, and I'm very sad.
All right, you're welcome back. Pretty soon we'll be talking about the Airtel Rising Stars. Of course, you know, it started a while back, just about a month or so ago. They've been nationwide. They've chosen some players, so we'll be talking about it. But before we go, can you guess his favorite food? Of course, he said fufu.
Yes.
And ebunu.
Yes.
Or do you like any other soup?
Granite.
Chicken or goat?
Goat. Maybe I mean a crantianswa.
All right, so that's your favorite meal.
Yeah.
Who's your favorite designer?
Bibri.
Okay. Mention two of them.
How are you watching two?
Guess.
Step
up. He said he's got a clothing line, so...
Yeah.
But I never...
So it's not your favorite?
Or Sack.
Kofi and Sack.
Okay, Step Up and Sack collection.
Yeah.
Okay, so I got Step Up.
Right? Step Up and Sack. What's your favorite designer, Agyeman?
Okay,
Agyeman, are you nervous?
No, I'm not.
Okay, the way you're rubbing your fingers. Yeah.
Well, why are you watching my fingers?
I have to watch it because no, I watch everything.
You have to watch my face.
Yeah.
Are you shy to watch my face?
Sorry? I'm shy? Yeah. No, I'm not shy of anything in this world. At all. Never been. Can you look me in the eye for 1 minute?
Yes, I can.
Go on. Don't blink. We'll be right back.
Laughing.
Okay, so I'm being told that it's not time for break yet. Let me come to you. Let's talk about the Black Stars. They have to beat Zambia. And when we say beat Zambia, we mean it. Because if you don't beat Zambia, this country will be too small for you guys.
Is that a threat?
Oh, is that a threat? Oh, but you know what we can
do. Attack, Nana.
No, no, not on you alone. On the Black Stars, the team.
Yeah,
I'm sure you've had a feel. If when you lose in Zambia, when you guys were kicked out of the African Cup of Nations in South Africa, you had a feel.
Yeah, for
of
sure.
How
because
upset Ghanaians can be.
Yeah, for sure. We felt it, but that's the nature of the game. It's, we went there for the ultimate, but unfortunately we couldn't get it. And yeah, we felt it, but what can we do? We just have to just forget about it. Then we concentrate on the next games.
Okay, I see. And you guys have to beat Zambia.
Yeah, talking about Zambia, yeah, it's going to be a very difficult game. They have nothing to lose because they just need a win. We need draw or a win. And playing in Kumasi, I know we're going to get a great support from Kumasi,
definitely.
Whether on Friday or Monday or whatever.
prefer playing in Kumasi to Accra?
Yeah, sure. I have,
but I understand they got friends from Zambia in Kumasi.
Yeah,
these
but
days. I don't know how.
We don't care about anything.
Yeah.
The most important thing is we have to be very vigilant because their FA president have talked, their captain and the goalkeeper as well. When you have a game against someone in 3 months or 2 months, and their people start talking, that means we have to be very vigilant.
Mm-hmm.
We are relaxed. Most of the players are on holidays. Others have gone for their preseason. When the time comes, we come back and fight for the nation. But with the support, commitment, and everything, they don't have chance in Ghana.
They don't have any chance. They can't even have a chance.
We don't need the draw because we have to revenge the business twice.
Mm.
So we are going for the revenge, and whoever it is, we will qualify. But
yeah.
We have to say, you might need a hole.
Black Stars and their revenge.
Yeah, I know.
I'm praying for a revenge against Uruguay. And Suarez.
Maybe we will meet him in the World Cup or
and beat
I don't
them.
Know. Yeah, for sure.
And his hands are still there.
Who? Suarez.
No, we'll cut the hands no. Like when we play against them.
Oh, he hasn't
and
got
his
just
teeth are also there.
He's got his teeth as well.
Yeah.
Anyway, we'll go for some tidbits and I have to say thank you to you, Juliet, because I'm gonna take your seat away from you. Sorry. Do I have to apologize for taking your seat?
It's normal.
Yeah. Anyway, so let's go for the tidbit and welcome our next guest. I saw some more messages here. Nana Boateng says Agyeman Badu is really funny. Fufu and Ebunebunu. Wow, it's a great meal. I don't know what makes you think it's a funny meal. It's a great meal. I just love it as well. Smart says that check the posture of Agyeman Badu. So poised and composed. That guy is so humble. Kojomo still leading a discussion on Twitter, and I'm going to overlook that, Kojomo. Dennis says, Moses has impressed me the most. Moses Oja, he's the best young footballer in the country. Okay. Pizza Boy says, Nana, I love your shoes. Okay. Rex Forson says, Agyeman Badu looks like a quiet person on your show, but he's not quiet because he jokes a lot when the boys are in camp. Well, you're always comfortable in where... Oh, don't put my shoes on TV. What is that? Okay. Ekuya Eduse Poku says, well, Ekuya, what you're saying is absolutely untrue anyway. And Patrick says, I believe the boys will make us proud. Well, let's welcome you from Airtel. And you're here for the Rising Stars.
Airtel Rising Stars.
And you're doing this in conjunction with Arsenal.
That's correct.
Okay. You're the same team that brought in Tony Adams.
Yes.
Okay.
And Ray Parlo.
Okay. Arsenal. You support Arsenal as well?
Yes, I do.
Okay. Nice.
How and long I know you support Man U.
Of course. How long have you been supporting Arsenal?
For a while now.
For a while? Mm-hmm. Over a decade?
No, less than a decade.
Less than a decade?
Yes.
So you haven't seen Arsenal lift a trophy?
Nana, can I ask him a question?
Sure, please. Go ahead.
Is it true that your team is a supermarket? You only sell players?
That's not true. Arsenal is a very great team, okay. And watch out for the season coming up.
That's your break. It's an annual mantra. Watch out for us next season. Annual mantra.
Annual mantra, but just watch it. Watch out.
Yeah.
The dynamics have changed in this the English Premier League.
Because Alex Ferguson is out. You know that is what Arsenal is counting on now, right?
Mourinho's also in Chelsea.
Yeah. So you think that...
Man City has changed their coaches.
So what makes you think Arsenal stands a chance? If Mourinho is back in England and Man City have taken out their ever arrogant coach and, you know, with a man who knows his game very well in charge now. I mean, you still have the same coach.
We still have the same coach. We have great players.
Yes, you
We're buying some new ones.
Ooh.
And just watch out.
Who are you buying? They spent £5,000 on 28
Wait
players.
Wait until after they sign on the dotted line.
Anyway, you follow Arsenal?
Yeah, a bit.
What do you think about Arsenal?
Yeah, they have a very good side. They believe in young players. And I think the man is going to change things this year. Hopefully, maybe if they get a striker like Higuain, the team will be fantastic.
Higuain has been signing for the past 3 years.
Yeah, because Nana, they have excellent midfield.
Mm-hmm. Oh yeah, yeah, absolutely.
With a finisher like Higuain, they will be fantastic this year. But watch out, the man is back.
Mm.
Mourinho.
Yes, Mourinho is also back in England.
Yeah,
so I think Mourinho will flop.
No.
He will flop. You should understand me. I don't like Chelsea. Liverpool. What's new? What are we expecting from Liverpool this season, please? Where is Jonjo Shelvey? I think they sold him to Swansea.
And you don't lose
Suarez. Yes. You don't lose your biter.
Yes.
Anyway, let's talk about the Rising Stars. Where have you reached now?
We're going to the finals of Ether Rising Star next week, Sunday. That will be the final match. We'll be playing it at the Carl Reindorff Stadium,
okay,
at the Dansoman. And there have been great players who have come out of the Northern and Southern Zone. We have the Northern Zone and the Southern Zone. The winners of Northern and Southern Zone will meet in the national finals in Accra, Dansoman.
Mm.
The winner of Ghana will go and meet the winners of all the African countries that Ether Rising Stars play, not the 17 countries.
Mm-hmm.
They're meeting in Lagos, Nigeria, for the Ether Rising Stars African Championships. Last year, I think the ladies team won the African Championships. After the...
Anything associated with Arsenal, the ladies win. I mean, the Arsenal ladies have been winning the premiership in England for, you know, God knows.
But you know, Arsenal has a very, very great youth program, like
yeah, they do.
With Etalis and the link with the Etal Rising Stars.
But I would have thought that for the final, you would invite maybe Theo Walcott, somebody the boys identify with. Walcott, which other player is so popular in your team anyway?
Well, you see, it all depends on the finals. The Africa finals will be in September.
Okay.
If any of the Arsenal players will be available, they may bring some down. If Walcott's available, we'll bring him down for maybe
the season would have started.
Sitting. It also depends. So, yeah, so after the finals, we're going to have a coaching clinic also in Nigeria. The Arsenal coaches will come down with a few other mentors, if we're able to get them, to coach the young boys and girls.
Okay, it would be nice, you know. It would be very nice for these boys, you know, to just see Walcott, Wilshere, you know, and the others. Mm-hmm. It would be pleasant. Anyway, so, you know, you take them that far, and then what happens to them after?
We're working with the National Juvenile Committee, Ministry of Youth and Sports,
okay,
where a lot of the rising stars get infused into the under 6, under 17, under 16, under 21, if they get up to mature up to that age.
Right.
And then they all enter into the, get fused into
so
the
So we are seeing our team. Next yes. Agyeman Badus and the, you know, Inkums and the Sulemuntaris.
Yeah, they've been great players coming out of the north and southern zones. And we will see some of them progress into the national teams.
Okay.
A good example is Priscilla Autry, who...
Priscilla. Yes. Yeah, Priscilla did great.
Is an Eta Rising Star.
Yeah.
She led the Black the Maidens Black to Maidens, the World
yeah.
Cup.
Yeah.
Scored a winning goal. And quite recently, she's been honored by SWAC, Sports Writers Association of Canada.
Yeah.
So there are a lot of great rising stars coming out of this Eta Rising Stars
Fantastic.
Program.
Fantastic. Congratulations.
Who comes out of this season three.
Congrats. Etel and Arsenal, you've done great. Agyeman, you know, I'm sure in your time, you didn't have anything like this. You know, you had to
struggle,
hustle. What was it like for you as you were coming up?
It was very difficult a bit because look at where I come from, you know.
It's in Nketiah's place.
Quite well, Papa. I worked very hard. At first, my mom wasn't supporting because I was a bit good in school, you know. So mm-hmm. they wanted me to concentrate on the education. And all my brothers and sisters, everyone is like the education side. So I choose to just divert to football. And mm-hmm. gradually, she understood me. And I came to Brekum, played for Berlin FC before moving to Brekum Arsenal for 1.5 years. I came to Asante Kotoko for 1 year alone. Unfortunately, I played only 2 games. And we went to the Chan Games in Cote d'Ivoire.
Mm-hmm.
We came back and I got a chance to play for the National Under 20 team. That's where we won the WAFU in Nigeria and Africa as well. And we went to the World Cup and won it as well. And from there, I moved to Udinese.
Yeah. It's been... So I'm sure your mother is very proud of you.
Very, very. Anything else should anyway, Fufu,
I knew that would come up.
Things have changed, you know.
Things have changed.
Before,
now,
you know, those days, my brothers, when they go to play ball and they get back home, trust me,
they get a good spanking
from my mom.
Yeah.
You know, but now a lot of people, you know, the games have changed. You see how the footballers are doing, the money involved, the hype, the fame, and all that. A lot of parents are not even taking their awards to
soccer academies
and all that. It's not like
you
that,
give that,
you know,
to a baby boy, you say, hey, take the ball. You're
and
the
they
next
thought that done. Footballers were kobolos those days.
Yeah, of course.
People want to have education as well as football. And my brother tells me, when I have a baby boy, I'll tie his leg by football. So you must play. If you can't play, you have to catch. You know? That's how things have changed.
That's very, very, very interesting. And I'm sure that you looked at all these stories and then you came up with this brilliant, extremely brilliant idea to do the Ethel Rising Stars.
Yes.
Yeah.
And also to add about the importance of education. We're working with the Ministry of Education to make sure that anyone who is an Ethel Rising Stars is in school.
Mm. Fantastic.
So that when
if you're not in school,
you cannot be part of Ethel Rising Stars. Mm-hmm. And for every goal that is scored during this tournament, Ethel Rising Stars, Airtel is going to donate 100 Ghana cedis per goal.
Okay.
And the total goals and total proceeds will be used to support two needy schools in Ghana.
Oh, that's a brilliant idea. That's a brilliant idea. Anyway, so before we take a break, let me tell you that the movie of the year, of course, Contract, produced by Yvonne Okoro, is out on VCD and DVD. And there is a chance for you to have dinner with Yvonne Okoro, because there's a promotion out there. When you buy the CD, you take a picture of the case and you post it on Twitter or Facebook or Instagram. Her handle is at Yvonne Okoro, and then you will stand the chance of being selected randomly for a paid dinner with Yvonne Okoro. I hear there's an association on Twitter, Yvonne Okoro Groupies Association Yoga, spearheaded by Tennis Kweku Seto. We'll be right back. Stay with us. You're welcome back. Thanks to Cookies Parlor in Osu for my hair and Rated Clothing as well for my outfit here, and of course these lovely earrings. And we were talking about the Airtel Rising Stars and football development, the opportunities available for young boys these days and even young women, because the women football is also gaining a lot of momentum now. In the past, you know, we thought that women playing football, I mean, it's so not ish. But now you have girls playing football. Would you date a footballer? would you?
No.
Why?
Because I already have someone, so it's difficult for me.
No, I mean, would you,
like,
given the chance, I mean, if you met a lady today and she played football and you really loved her,
okay,
would her career be an inhibition?
Yeah, because I need attention, and if she can't give me the attention, I can't.
Okay, so, okay, because she'll be away most of the time.
Exactly.
So you want attention?
Yes.
So what do you want, a housewife?
Not a housewife per se, but at least
she should always be there.
Yeah, not the work I'm doing, then she also doing the same work.
I get it.
It's hectic, you know.
Yeah, it is. So you're dating now?
Yes, please.
Who?
She's there.
What's her name?
Her name?
Yeah.
Nana Wai. She's quite Agyeman.
She's
Why not?
Agyeman Wa. Anyway, good. So we wish you all the best. When is the wedding? Coming soon to a church near me.
God knows.
All right. God knows. It's a sound man's name in TV3. God knows. Anyway, so what's the price package, really? I mean, these kids, of course, you're giving them all the opportunities of exposure. But is there a price package? Because in other competitions, they're getting, you know, money, some taking them to Chelsea. Do they stand a chance of probably going for trials at Arsenal?
Well, there's a bit of some money, there's a trophy, but okay, the main thing is the platform to be able to meet the scouts. And if you're very, very good and a scout meets you or sees you and thinks that you're up to it, the sky's the limit for you.
Okay, fantastic. Anyway, we have just about 2 minutes to wrap up. Agyeman Badu, I'm very happy you... Well, I wasn't going to ask you any questions. I'm just going to express my gratitude to you for passing through. And there are several messages on Twitter for you. People really love you, and they love your success. Right, so thank you so much for passing through. We wish you all the best. Invite me to that wedding.
For sure, I will.
Okay. Sandra, you were late, but I forgive you. Nice seeing you again. And thank you.
Thank you.
You know, congrats again, Airtel and Arsenal. I think it's a fantastic idea.
Thank you. So brilliant. Sunday, I think that's the finals. Everyone should make their way to Dansoman.
The Carl Randolph Park.
Randolph Park for the final match.
Right. Thank you very much. So get your contract on VCD and DVD. That'll be all for today. We'll see you next week. Mommy, meet
your mommy. Hey.